Hello, my name is Kushal Engade, and today we will discuss about the erythroblastosis fetalis. Now, what is meant by erythroblastosis fetalis? This is the condition occurs in fetus where there is a erythrocyte undergoes the destruction. It is the condition where the erythrocyte or the RBC undergoes the destruction. So that's why it is called as the erythroblastosis fetalis. But why this condition occurs, we will learn here step by step. So see here that when the maternal antibodies, particularly IgG, so when these maternal antibodies enter or cross through the placenta into the fetal circulation, at the time they destroy the fetal RBC. But why these antibodies are entered into the fetal circulation? Because these antibodies are specific for the fetal blood group antigens. Now the transfer of these antibodies can be minor, serious, or it may cause the death of that fetus also. And in case if there is a severe hemolytic disease, at the time it is called as the erythroblastosis fetalis. Now most commonly it is developed when mother and fetus shows or express the different alleles of the rhesus antigen. It means that mother and the fetus, they are not showing the same type of rhesus antigen, they are showing the different types of the antigen. So there are 5 different alleles of the Rh antigen. Out of that 5, allele D or D allele, that is also called as the RhD or Rh positive. This is responsible for the strongest immune response. When Rh negative mother carry an Rh positive fetus, at that time mother can be sensitized by fetal RBCs that enter the maternal circulation usually during the childbirth. So what happens here that during the childbirth, the fetal RBC enter into the maternal circulation and where they will elicit the immune response. Now these antibodies, that is IgG antibodies, are generated into the Rh negative mothers during the second pregnancy, or we can say the subsequent pregnancy, in which if the fetus is again Rh positive, at the time the second fetus is at risk because the maternal anti-Rh antibodies, these anti-Rh antibodies, nothing but the here the IgG antibodies. So these antibodies can cross the placenta and mediate the destruction of the fetal RBCs. And if there is a destruction in fetal RBCs, this is called as the erythroblastosis fetalis. It is also called as the HDN, that is hemolytic disease of the newborn, and may be serious or lethal for the fetus. So we'll use this picture for the better explanation. So see here, this is the first pregnancy where the fetus having that Rh positive blood group. This is the RBC which having that antigen. So this is the Rh positive fetus, this is a placenta, and this is the maternal circulation. We know that mother is Rh negative and fetus is Rh positive. So what happens during delivery is that when the RBC, when they crosses the placenta, or we can say that this RBC comes in contact with the maternal circulation during the delivery. Okay. After reaching into the mother's circulation, this RBC will activate the immune response, or will generate the immune response into the mother's blood or mother's body. So these are the B cells, these are Rh specific B cell, and these are responsible for the production of antibodies to destroy this RBC, that is fetal RBC. So after some time, we know that these are the plasma cells. Plasma cell means what? These are the special B cells which having the ability to secrete the antibodies. And these are the memory cells. So memory cell will memorize that which type of antigen was present into the body or the blood. Okay. Now, reaching up to the second pregnancy. So what happens during the second pregnancy? If the fetus is again Rh positive, means that RBC of that fetus is containing same type of antigen. So we know, on the other hand, the mother's circulation or mother's blood carrying that memory cell. So by chance, if the antibodies, if they reach into the fetus or this RBC, again by chance, if they reach up to the mother circulation, at that time they will generate the immune response. This RBC from the fetus, if they reach up to the mother's blood, at that time they will come in contact with the memory cell, and memory cell, we know, they know how to produce the, or which type of antibody should be produced against this RBC. So here After reaching up to the mother circulation, the memory cell will become the active. They will produce the further plasma cell. Plasma cell will produce the antibodies. Now, these antibodies will reach up to the fetal circulation. Okay, here, fetal circulation. And after reaching there, these antibodies will destroy the RBCs of the fetus. So, at that time, the condition will arise that is called as the erythroblastosis fetalis. This condition can be prevented with the help of the Rogam. Now, Rogam is what? These are the special antibodies, nothing but these antibodies are produced against the antigen. Okay. So, mother is treated with this Rogam. Okay. Now, after taking that Rogam by the mother, these Rogam means these antibodies will destroy whatever the RBCs are present into the mother circulation, which are released by the fetus during the second pregnancy. So, these RBC will be destroyed by the Rogam, and that's why if there is no RBC in mother circulation, what will happen? It will prevent the B cell activation. This step, okay, it will further prevent the B cell activation, and there is no memory cell formation. It means that there is no antibody formation and there is no erythroblastosis fetalis. So, it was all about the erythroblastosis fetalis. Now, see what happens during this condition, that is erythroblastosis fetalis, that we know into the fetus circulation that whatever the RBCs are there, the RBC undergoes the destruction. If there is an abnormal destruction of RBC, what will happen? That whatever the hemoglobin is there, which is present in that RBC, that hemoglobin will convert into the bilirubin. Okay, but actually these RBCs are destroyed in blood, okay, and not their exact particular place where they should be destroyed. That's why bilirubin, it is now present in blood. And we know bilirubin is yellowish in color. So, because of that bilirubin, that skin will become the yellowish in color. We know that condition is nothing but it is similar to the jaundice. So, we will not say that fetus is suffering from the jaundice, but actually the condition is somewhat similar to the jaundice. Okay. And this bilirubin, nothing but it is toxic for the body. This bilirubin can cross the lipid bilayer. It will reach up to the brain. It can easily enter into the cells, and where it will cause the brain damage. So nothing but to avoid this condition into the newborn baby, what is going on there? Which care is taken here? That the newborn baby is exposed to the mild UV light. Now why that newborn baby is exposed to the mild UV light? Because this ultraviolet light or UV light will destruct, or we can say the breakdown the bilirubin. So whatever the bilirubin which is present into that newborn baby, that bilirubin will be split by this UV light, and it will further minimize the brain damage in that newborn baby. So it was all about this erythroblastosis fetalis, and these are the references which I have used here. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. It will be beneficial for your syllabus or study. Thank you so much.